go skydive or anything.
Oh, really?
So cute.
I would, but I'm adventurous like that.
I'm kind of happy.
And then the way they inject it, I mean, put it in now.
Yeah, but here.
Oh, just that's like,
get ready.
Yeah.
The black?
Yeah.
I'm
good. Wait, did it do anything?
Yeah, it looks good, but I wouldn't touch it. Because you don't want to mess up your hair.
It does
look
good. Okay.
Can you get the rest of the white
things? There are some in here. She wants to take a picture.
Okay. What are we going to do? Should we all sit on bed?
Yes. I don't know what she wants. Yes? Mm-hmm.
Look at each other.
Love it.
This
is just for the dark part.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
We can leave you alone.
I think the voice can.
How about you get him done and then let me get them?
No. Actually, now it's really harder for them to pop if you like stick
their boobs. I guess it's time to put a shirt on.
I don't know what you're doing.
Message could not be sent.
Hi, Smiley. Hey, hi, laugh. Look at each other.
Perfect.
Drink.
Now we're going to take away the glasses.
Remember what your glasses were.
That was good. Drop it.
There you go.
That's
weird, isn't it?
Yeah,
okay. I'm going to look at Lara and Lara. You just look at me.
Okay.
One more of those.
Cute.
Look at your sister, Lara.
No.
Thank you.
Father, we come before you, and Lord, we thank you just for this wedding, for everyone who's coming and just serving and helping. Lord, we pray just that you would bless this marriage as we start, just with your presence as we come to worship you and seek you. God, we come before you asking for just your intimacy, your nearness, to come and convict hearts and move hearts, that as we do come before you, God, that it would be more than just a service, but that we would actually come to worship you and to seek you and to praise you for what you have done for us in giving us your Son to redeem us to you, that we could have fellowship with you, that we could come into your presence. So we come before you, God, and we pray for this wedding, we pray for this marriage, just that you would be the center of it, that your presence would be heavy upon our hearts, that we would seek you first all of our days, that we would find our joy, our pleasure, our satisfaction in you alone, that you would be the center of our lives. Lord, we pray, come, pour out your Spirit upon this marriage and give us grace. Give us grace to love. Give us grace to be humble and selfless, to serve one another, to wash each other's feet. God, we come before you and we thank you, Lord, for bringing us together and making this happen. Just everything that you have done, Lord, we thank you and we bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen, amen. Praise God. Oh.
Huh? So don't smash the flowers.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Revelation 21:3, and it says, "Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men. He shall be our God, and we shall be his people."
Awesome.
Oh my gosh.
You said it was going to be a long dress.
It's long, not a short dress.
No, but not.
Oh, my train's long.
Oh, you still have something else? Okay. All right.
Yeah.
My baby.
All of her that.
Beautiful. Daniel, you are the star of the show.
The star of the show.
Don't break the egg.
I'm going to feel like it. No?
We're just going to walk normal.
What is normal?
Like we practiced yesterday.
Okay, okay. Now, the chapel, is it going to be full?
I don't think so. I don't think the sides will be.
Yay. All right.
One last picture?
Yes, now a formal picture.
Now formal.
Beautiful.
While we are gathered here today to celebrate the lives of these two and hopefully get them hitched by the end of the afternoon, your life now, this moment forward, it's a parable. And people will be watching. And I know both of you well to know this parable is going to be one we're all going to want to read. Your lives now before the Lord and before everyone else are a picture of the union that the Lord wants to have with us. And so I give you this final charge. Let nothing hinder your love for one another. Well, at this time, Mark and Lara would like the opportunity to tickle each other's toes. I mean, wash each other's feet as an expression of servanthood for one another. And so you guys go ahead, come forward.
Lara Marisa, my best friend, the apple of my eye, the one in whom my soul has been searching for and whom my soul longs to be with forever. These are my vows. I vow to be faithful to you, to make a covenant with my eyes, honest and open with you in my mistakes, with the stress and frustrations in my heart, about what I am thinking and feeling, to always listen to you, to take time out of every day that we are given to be with you, to give my life for your protection and provision, as well as our children. To love the Lord our God with all of my heart, writing his commandments on my heart and teaching our children to follow him and to obey the gospel. I vow to love you as my own body, to nourish and cherish you. I vow to be jealous for you, to diligently seek your heart all our days. I vow to lead you and guide you through the valley low or up on the mountain, to carry you when you are too weak to go on. My one vow that I wish to forever keep, that I consider the greatest of all vows, is to love you as Christ has loved me. That though I never gave him reason to love me, he has poured out his love into my heart. And that is how I wish to love you, for better, for worse, to love you not because of who you are, but to love you because the Father has so loved me. So with this wing, I commit myself to these vows before the Lord and men to be yours for all of our days.
Mark Rodney Stokes. Day by day I love you more. Since day one, you never cease to amaze me, inspire me, and woo me. I promise to love you at the deepest level and to offer you my fullest devotion for the rest of our lives. I promise to care for you tenderly and to be faithful to you through whatever life may throw our way. I commit to be devoted to our Lord alongside you so that I can love and serve you to my fullest capacity. I commit to be sensitive to the Holy Spirit so that he may lead me to be a godly wife. I will give you my love daily by supporting you, respecting you, and encouraging you, and inspiring you. You can count on me to stand by your side through every season, to never stop believing in you, and to kiss you at every red light. Mark Rodney Stokes, with this ring I give you my heart. I promise from this day forward you shall not walk alone, but will always find a helper, and a lover, and a friend in me.
Well, with these vows and these rings, it's my great pleasure to now pronounce you man and wife. Mark, you may kiss your bride. May I now take the pleasure of, for the first time, introducing you to Mr. and Mrs. Mark Stokes. Well, at this time, the bride and groom would like to invite you to join them at a reception at the Reata. It begins at 4 o'clock, so we'll see you there.
Thank you.
Okay, so for my brother, but truly for the Lord and what my brother's done, because I've known my brother my whole life. And if this were to happen, even without the Lord, people would probably call it successful and great. But I got to know my brother before and after. And beforehand, I wasn't a good brother to him. But now I get to share the Lord's love with him and celebrate this time. And I get to see how the Lord has blessed his life. And how he has true life now, and he has joy and peace in his heart. And I'm not scared about his marriage because he looks to the Lord. He trusts in the Lord, and I know the Lord's faithful, and he's our shepherd. And he's going to lead him into righteousness, and he's going to continue to just let this marriage be a blessing and a testimony, as Brad said today about his silent leadership. And so I'm thrilled because I get to watch my... And I get to have my brother next to me who fights the same fight, and he has his own calling, and he's walking out in the beauty of the way that God called him to be, and he's loving Lara, this wonderful woman, and I'm like so pleased because it's a true blessing, and I get to see what God brought into my brother's life. I've never seen a gift so great from my brother to just always have a smile on his face and to love this girl with such crazy love. He was just, you know, intoxicated with her love. I got to watch it and I got to see it go through, and so I'm just so blessed to get to be a part of it. So anyways, bless you.
Just wanted to express how happy I am for my sister. She's, sorry, I'm trying to get it together. She's been a wonderful woman of God since we've known. I mean, she grew up knowing the Lord, but in her teenager years, she started to get more serious and start to focus. As soon as my brother Sam just spoke into her life that she was going to be a woman of God, and her heart for kids and her heart for the ministry, that she just knew that's where she had to be no matter what. College wasn't important, it was God that was important. And also my mom and Sam, like when she was 12, she knew that she wanted to marry a man of God, and he had to have a servant's heart and just be gung-ho for the Lord. And as soon as she met Mark, she knew that was the one. And so we're so excited that she found her mate and the one that God has brought for her. And just happy to see that all her fruits are coming, gonna blossom in her marriage, all the gifts that the Lord has bestowed upon her. And we just love you. Love you.
If I Thank you. Oh, no.
Oh, I hear this.
Okay.
Let us out first before y'all get out, though.
Okay. So we can get the haircut.
Okay. Yeah, I gotta get my bag.
Oh, yeah.
Walk over with him.
All right.
But he cannot go from here to there without.
Tell them I'm on.
You're on there. Tell Alfredo you're on there?
Tell Alfredo.